Okay, so I want to talk a little bit about logarithms and their relationship to exponential functions. Okay, so and that requires us to talk a little bit about the idea of inverse functions. We won't do this in depth, but you kind of need to at least have an idea of what inverse functions are to get this, the idea of logarithms. So inverse functions are functions that undo each other. And you know quite a few of them. And I'll just give you a pretty standard example. One function is the function x squared. Right? And I know that if I need to get rid of or undo something that's squared, I take the square root. Right? These are functions that undo each other. Okay? So, and what another way to look at that is that if I start over here with an input of x is equal to 4, right, and take that in f of x, f of 4 is equal to 4 squared, right? That gets over to 16. Okay, now if I want to go back this other direction, what I do is put that 16 into the square root and I get back to 4. Okay, so there are functions that kind of go in this circular pattern, and this circular pattern holds in this particular case for all negative numbers, right? So this is a circular pattern that holds and is valid, okay? So this is what, and we say in this case, like x squared and the square root of x are inverse functions, they're functions that undo each other. Now, I don't know if you, and you probably have never thought about who actually came up with this idea of taking a square root or where that came from. And the reality is that's just a notation we use to do this, to go back the other direction, right? Like, I don't want to square something, I want to go back the other direction. Okay? And we invented at some point this notation that said, hey, if I want to go back and undo what the square function does, then I can use the square root notation to indicate that. Okay, so the same thing is true now. I want to go to what we have been talking about, these functions, exponential functions, b to the x power, right? Where b is some positive number. Okay, and not equal to 1. Let's cross all the t's and dot all the i's, right? Okay, so I want to think about those functions and think about the idea that the variable is right up here. Okay, so now for example, I will have a problem where I want to solve this maybe 5 is equal to, let's say, 3 to the x power. And I want to figure out what the solution is. And right now, in everything that you have done algebraically, we don't have tools to do that. Okay? I can't just divide both sides by 3. That's 3 raised to the x power. Dividing by 3 doesn't undo that, right? It doesn't undo what I did. Okay? So, in order to do this and in order to think about solving problems where I do have x's in this exponent, I want to define or in some ways invent this log function. Okay? This is a very standard function. So I want to define a function that undoes what exponential functions do. Okay, and those functions are called logarithms. Okay, So here's how I wanted to find this. Let's say I have this exponential equation. Equation, I can spell it today, right? And let's say I have A is equal to B to the C power. Okay, that's some exponential equation, and I have different things in here. Okay, so I'm just using these as placeholders. Okay, and what I would like to do is define something that makes C, that number that is in the exponent, and is hard to get to, not in the exponent anymore, right? So I can go over, I'm just going to define this log equation, logarithmic equation. That looks like this. We define a log. It has the same base as my exponential function. That's my base. But instead of taking C as an input, C is now the output and A is the input. So I want you to take a look here. This is the input. Now here it's the output of this log. Over here, A was the output. And now it gets switched to the input, right? This roll log functions like this exponent right here. Okay? Now, because okay, actually, let's just do an example of using this different notation. So we can just switch back and forth between these two forms of exponential and log equations. So let's do that. So convert to a log equation. I have 3 squared equals 9. Okay, and this is my equation where I said I in this case b to the c power is a, right? I'm identifying, to me this is a lot like those quadratic equations where you just identify these pieces, or you can think of it in terms of this base, input, or output, right? And I want to go over to this log equation. So that is log, it's the same base, b. A is equal to c. C is now the output. So here, let's see, this is log base 3 in this case. A is 9 and C is 2. Okay? I'm just switching forms, okay? And a lot of times you just switch forms to see which one is more useful to use. Okay, so we want to, let's switch back the other direction. Convert to an exponential equation. Okay. Let's do log base 3 of 5 is equal to y. Okay, so going here, I have this log, usually I'm using base b of a is equal to c, and I go to this exponential where b is the base, c is here in the exponent, and a is out here. So when I do that, I get b is 3, a is 5, and c is y. Okay? Okay, so this, and this is the final answer. This is the same form in this exponential equation form. Okay, so I'll make a note. So you can have logs of any base. So let me talk a little bit about bases. You can have logs of any base. We do typically write log base b of whatever. Let's say it's of a is equal to c. I can have logs of any base. So, like in the examples, I can have log base 2 of 3. That's perfectly legitimate. We still do restrict these bases for b to be positive and b not equal to 1, just like we did with the exponential functions. And that makes sense because these log functions are based off of those exponential functions. Now, we have two special bases, and we'll talk in particular about one of them, but I want to make sure that you know what these two special bases are. One is log base 10, so log base 10 of, let's say, 3. And usually we don't write the 10. So usually you'll see this written as just log 3. And when there's no base, then that means it's base 10. Okay? It's just one of the bases that gets used all the time. Okay? And you'll see on your calculator the LOG button, like that. That is not log base whatever, that's log base 10. Okay? Okay. Now, the other log that we use quite a bit is log base e. So let's say log base e of 17, right? This is called the natural log. And you'll see that written as ln of 17. Again, no base indicated, and it's really not written log. And this is what you see on your calculator as ln. Okay? Okay, so that's a brief introduction to logs. We're going to talk about some log properties. We will mostly be dealing with natural logs in this particular course and talk about how to take derivatives of them and that stuff. So please let me know if you have questions.